Hey, it's JC here at JC's Comics and More, your pop culture superstore at 6725 West Central Avenue, that's Toledo, Ohio, 43617-419-531-6097. Find us on Facebook in the description below. JC's Comics and More at hotmail.com. This is the last day of Thursday, June 30th. I've got quite a few, as you can see. Lots of yellow sticky bags in there that we've been debagging and getting ready to do bag and process. But here's some of the ones that we're getting ready to process now. Super Team Family, Giant Super Team Family number one. Multiple copies, jumps to number 4, 5, 6. These are all nice reprints. 7, 8 dinosaurs. That's a brand new Rich Buckler cover. His Tyrannosaurus, as always, were very teethy. We've got 9. We've got 11s, several 11s. With Supergirl, The Flash, and The Atom. We've got Kong the Untamed. Kong the Untamed. Shoot 2, that's a Bernie Wrightson cover. 3. We've got 4. We've got several 5s. Quite a few 5s there. Richard Dragon, Kung Fu Fighter, number 1. Hey, how's it going there, Mark? There's number 2, 3. I had the 4. I think the 4, or was it the 6? Had the first appearance of Lady Shiva. We sold that already. There's a 7. There's an 8. In fact, there's several 8s. Several 8s. There's 9. We got 10. You can tell that these are subscription copies because it's got the folded. So as the postman would put them in the mail, he would fold them in half to make sure they fit that mailbox. 11. There's 11s. There's 12s. 13. Look at that. Look at that punch, man. Look at that kick. 13. 14. Sixteens, lots of 16s here, 17s, we've got 18 with the Bronze Tiger, we've got a Marvel Chillers featuring Tigra, the Weir Woman, great John Byrne artwork there, look at that, John Byrne's artwork, man, he drew a smoking hot Tigra, and this has Red Wolf in it as well. And then at the end, you find out that the Super Skrull. Look at that! Oh, damn cool, John Byrne, man. Got a Kirby cover on this one here, but George Tuska did the art. Not as good as John, as Byrne, but still pretty damn solid work nonetheless. Couple of 7s. We've got supervillain team ups. 1. We've got 2, 3, 4. And these books jumped around. I think Herb Tramp. No, it started with George Tuska. You got Sal Buscema. You've got George Evans. See, each issue, it just jumped around. You got Herb Tramp. Herb Tramp finally took over on a fairly regular basis. This was published bi-monthly as well. But you've got Tramp again. I think that was an Alan Weiss cover with John Romita doing some faces, redrawn faces there. The Herb Tramp. Buckler cover. Tramp. And you've got Kissinger there. Issue 8. It's still bi-monthly. Then you got Keith Giffen came on board. Steve Englehart was writing. Steve Englehart, who wrote the ones from the beginning here? Jim Shooter wrote issue 3. 2 was written by Tony Isabella. So it jumped around. Bill Mantlo wrote a couple as well before Englehart sort of got the nod. Like I said, Keith Giffen came on board. This crossed over with Avengers, I believe 150, 153, 154. And this had Bill Mantlo, Jim Shooter did the art on this one here. Several of those. Love this book. Love the white background with the red, the blue, that powder blue. You got Gil Kane doing the cover, Bill Mantlo, and then Bob Hall came on board. It happens this issue. The Red Skull returns. Then you got Dave Cockrum cover. Bill Mantlo, Bob Hall. Last Stand in Latveria. Another Cockrum cover. Bill Mantlo, Bob Hall. Look at Dr. Doom just standing his ground. It's like the Red Skull blasted him. He's not cowering at all. He's like, bring it on, bitch. As they would say. I'm not quite the juggernaut, but, you know. And look how many number 12s there are. I forgot. This had, look at all these 12s. You need another 12? Who needs a 12? You need a 12. You need a 12. You need a 12. You need a 12. And you need a 12 too. Here's the subscription copy. Finally, done with the 12s. We've got a Kirby cover here. Kirby and you can tell that John Romita worked on some of the faces there. I think this might be Kirby and maybe Frank Giacola. Doesn't quite look like Joe Sinnott. But maybe Al Milgram. Might be Al Milgram inks. But Bill Mantlo, Keith Giffen. You got a John Byrne cover, Byrne in Austin. This is a pretty damn good issue also. And you've got Bill Mantlo, Bob Hall, Don Perlin. But you look at Magneto here, that face looks like it was redrawn by George Tuska. That's a George Tuska face right there, if I've ever seen one. And issue number 16, the Red Skull and the Hate Monger together. Of course, they're Nazis. Why wouldn't they be together? Peter Gillis came on board with Carmen Infantino. And then we got the Cosmic Cube. It's all, you know, got rid of Dr. Doom and the Submariner, and it's now the Hate Monger and the Red Skull. All Nazi team up. Peter Gillis, Arvel Jones, several of the 17s. And you got Supervillain team up where it all started. Got a Rich Buckler cover. This is Roy Thomas, John Buscema, Joe Sinnott. So you know it's going to be solid. And then you've got some backup reprints there. There it is. It goes back to when they first. So you got a quick little 8-page story there. And it kind of showed you how they got together. Now this is all new. Gil Kane cover. Roy Thomas. Mike Sadowski doing that. And then you've got some reprints again. You've got a Spider-Man reprint. Spidey versus the Living Brain from issue 8. Here we got All-Star Comics Presents, number 58. First appearance of Power Girl. I had a lot of other All-Star Comics, but so did a great majority of them. We've got a number 60. We've got a number 61. And we've got a number 65. If you do like these videos, as always, let me just double check this to make sure there's nothing else there. If you do like these videos, be sure to certainly subscribe to the channel. If you've not subscribed to the channel yet, smash the bell for notification, like, comment, and share. I'll have more of these videos coming. I've got one Iron Man I've got to do, and there's one of the Moon Knights. A lot of stuff I've got to try and get processed by Saturday. I'm expecting some visitors from out of town. Might be visitors from maybe Wisconsin or Minnesota, and some in the Georgia area. Who knows? Maybe I've got some guys coming from Pittsburgh too. This is the weekend to come. You know, get these comics while you can. Thanks.